Hey guys, it's Megan, and in today's video, I'll be showing you how to make clay with things that you have at home. All you need are three simple ingredients: flour, salt, and water. Measure 2 cups of flour and 1 cup of salt into a large bowl. Mix the salt and the flour so it's combined evenly. Then add between 3/4 of a cup to 1 cup of warm water. Add less water than you think you'll need at first, because it's a lot easier to add more water than to take it away. But if you do add too much, you can just add a little more flour. I started mixing everything with a spoon, then kneaded it together with my hands. You'll want it to be about the consistency of Play-Doh. This clay that I made is also known as salt dough. It's traditionally something that people use to make Christmas ornaments. I've also seen it used to make paw prints or handprints, since the dough is non-toxic and it's safe for animals and small humans. Since this recipe made a lot, I put the salt dough in an airtight container while I worked so it wouldn't dry out. This will last for about a week if you don't want to use it all at once. Or you could just make a smaller batch. Now that our clay's ready, we can start making stuff with it. I recently made a bunch of wire rings, and I didn't really have a good place to store them. So the first project that I made was this mountain ring holder. First, take a little bit of clay and start rolling it into a snake. Start rolling the snake at one end first, so that this end is thinner. We're going for sort of a cone shape. And obviously, make sure that your rings can fit over it. That is super important. Once I had the shape how I wanted it, I cut off some of the excess at the bottom. Repeat this 2 more times, so you have 3 mountains altogether. For the base of my ring holder, I rolled out a piece of clay and arranged the mountains on top. I used an X-Acto knife to cut out sort of a squiggly, organic shape. To make sure the mountains stuck to the base, I scored the bottom of each one with an X-Acto knife, scored the base, then used water to stick it together. This step is super important if you want to stick multiple shapes together. Here's what it should look like so far. Now, you could let this air dry and flip it over every day for like a week, but I was way too impatient to do that. I got the best results by air drying the clay overnight and finishing drying them in the oven the next day. I set my oven to 200 degrees Fahrenheit. The length of time that you keep them in there depends on how thick your piece is. For this size, I put them in the oven for 2 hours, flipped it, then baked it for 2 more hours. You can put this in the oven right away without air drying it first, but I found that that made the clay more likely to crack and kind of like expand a little bit. When you take it out of the oven, let it cool for a while. I let mine sit overnight just to be 100% sure that they were dry. This is definitely a multiple day project. When the salt dough cools, you can sand it down to make it extra smooth. Now we can finally move on to painting. First, I covered my mountains with 2 coats of white acrylic paint. I wanted it to look like the mountains had snow at the top, so I used a small paintbrush to outline drips with some gray paint. I made the 2 outer mountains a light gray, and the middle mountain slightly darker. Again, I needed 2 coats of paint. And once that was dry, I sealed my ring holder with some clear satin polyurethane. If you have something with a gloss finish, that would definitely look better. It would give it more of like a ceramic look. But if you don't have polyurethane, you can use Mod Podge, clear spray paint, or anything else that you have on hand. And when that dries, you're all set. I think this turned out so cute, and it's a great way to store your rings. If you have a bunch of rings, you can make more of the mountains. Or you could make the base bigger and add sides to make it like a little dish. The next thing I made was this heart trinket dish. To make this, first I rolled out a piece of clay. Then I grabbed a piece of paper, folded it in half, and cut out a heart shape to use as a template. I put the template on top of the clay and cut around it with an X-Acto knife. If you can, I'd recommend making your clay projects directly on your baking sheet. That way you won't have to worry about moving them, especially if you added a little bit too much water and it turns out to be a little soft. I used the excess clay to make the sides of the dish. I rolled it into a long snake, then scored the heart with my knife. I put some water on top, then put the clay snake on top of that. I actually didn't score the bottom of the snake, I don't really know why, but it worked out fine. And I made the sides in 2 different sections. I used a little water to blend the seams together. I did that all around the sides as well, so everything would be blended together and it would look like one cohesive piece. I baked this the same way that I did the ring holder, at 200 degrees, but I left this one in for 6 hours since it was bigger. And just like before, after it cooled, I used sandpaper to make it nice and smooth. Then I painted it. Of course, with any of these projects, painting is completely up to you. I covered the top and bottom of my ring dish with some white acrylic paint. You can skip this step if you want. I just like to give it a nice clean base before I add the color. When that dried, I painted the top and bottom of the dish with some light purple paint. You don't really need to paint the bottom if you don't want to. I just like doing it to make it look a little bit more professional. And when that dried, I sketched out my design. I wanted to make a Powerpuff Girls style heart, except mine was obviously purple instead of pink. I just drew a bunch of hearts that got smaller as you got closer to the center. For the other colors, I used a dark purple, which ended up being super annoying and needing like 4 coats, and a sort of medium purple. I thought that it looked kind of weird having all the stripes in the middle but nothing on the outside, so I painted the edges with that medium purple. Again, I sealed that with some more polyurethane, and I was done. This goes great with the whole purple theme that I have going on in my room. It's great for storing any little knickknacks that might end up on my desk. Another thing that I made was this mountain paintbrush stand. I have a really bad habit of just leaving my paintbrushes in the water for like days at a time, and that really isn't the best thing for them. Especially these ones. These are like really terrible quality brushes, and leaving them in the water for any amount of time just makes like all the paint come off. To make this, I shaped the clay into sort of a thick rectangle. Then I used my X-Acto knife to draw the general mountain shape. I kind of just eyeballed it to make sure that the spaces between the mountains would be large enough to hold a paintbrush handle. I dipped my finger in a little water to smooth out the area between the mountains. I baked it just like we did before, and painted it pretty much the same way as I painted the ring holder. I started with a coat of white paint, then used a small paintbrush dipped in blue paint to look like snow on top of the mountains. Again, I covered the whole thing with polyurethane. And here's how the finished piece turned out. I honestly don't know if I'll remember to use this, but it is super cute. The last project I made was this leopard trinket dish. To make this, first I drew out a template to trace. I'll link the one that I made in the description if you don't feel like drawing out your own. I rolled out a thick layer of clay, put the template on top, and cut around it with an X-Acto knife. To make it more like a dish, I used my finger to kind of press down the middle and create a raised edge. And just like all the other projects, bake it at 200 degrees, let it cool, and sand it down. I think that I baked this one for about 6 hours, just like I did the heart dish. I painted the top and bottom of the dish white. Initially, I painted it this darker brown, but I didn't really like it, so I covered it up with a lighter brown. I made sure to paint the top and bottom, then added the face. I drew it in pencil first, then went over it with a black Posca pen. For the leopard spots, I scribbled in some small shapes with a brown Posca pen. While those were drying, I used a black Posca pen to add triangles to the feet for claws. To finish the leopard spots, I surrounded the brown dots with like some random squiggles of black. Really, what I did, I just looked up leopard spots and tried to copy that. Finish it off with a coat of polyurethane, and your leopard dish is ready to go. I love this one. I think it's so cute. You know, 10 out of 10, definitely recommend making this. Now, to end this video, I kind of wanted to show you guys the fails that happened along the way. I don't know, I just want to start being more real with you guys, and the reality is, a lot of times I try things and they do not work. I tried making beads, which you might have noticed earlier in the video. I thought that they would look kind of like those wooden beads, but the problem was when I baked them, the bottom just like was completely flat, and I tried to like sand them back into a sphere, but they were just really ugly and they did not look right. So that was like 3 hours that I'll never get back. I also tried to make this little frog with some extra clay, and this is what I meant about the clay cracking and how I found out that air drying them for a while before you bake them can help you avoid that. But yeah, that was everything for this video. Let me know which project was your favorite in the comments. I think mine was either the ring holder or the leopard dish. If you're not already and you'd like to be, make sure to subscribe for more videos just like this one. My merch, my website, and all of my social media will be linked down below. I love you guys so, so much, and I will see you guys later. Bye!